This is the third installment in my coverage series of the alien megastructure star mystery. For the backstory, check out my previous two videos on the subject. An interesting development has occurred in the KIC 8462852 or Tabby star story. A paper released just a few days ago lays out an interesting theory that may finally give a satisfying natural explanation for the phenomenon, but there's still a major problem, and alien megastructures still cannot be discounted. But we're a lot closer to that now. As is currently making the rounds in the media, a star with a very similar light curve to Tabby's star has been discovered. It's called EPIC 204278916, and contrary to what the media's headlines would have you believe, it is not a candidate for another Dyson sphere. The reason is that the star is very young, at less than 11 million years old. That is not enough time, by far, for a technological civilization to evolve in a star system, so this one is definitely not of alien origin. But in this case, scientists do have a good idea of what's causing the dips. Young star systems are loaded with dust, gas, and forming planets. When looked at with telescopes like Kepler, these systems show very noisy, erratic light curves. Most of the time, they don't really look like KIC 8462852's light curve, but in the case of EPIC 204278916, it looks very similar, albeit with much deeper dips. This is because we're seeing that star's disk from an edge-on point of view. The disk is uneven, so blocks light in a varying manner just like Tabby's star. It also produces a lot less infrared radiation than normal because it's edge-on. At EPIC, we see only a little. At Tabby, we see none, or at least our instruments aren't sensitive enough to see it if it's there. This new discovery would make for a fully reasonable explanation for Tabby's star. It's a young star system seen edge-on. But there are still a few problems. That does not explain the overall century-long dimming trend. That remains a mystery. And there's still one last issue that throws a wrench in the works. Tabby's star does not appear to be young. In fact, it seems to be very old. Old star systems do not have debris disks, those having long before condensed into planets and asteroids. So for this new theory to work, Tabby's star must appear old when it really isn't. This seems to be the direction that thinking on Tabby's star is moving. If it can be demonstrated that the star appears older than it really is, then alien megastructures can be eliminated as a cause and the mystery of Tabby's star will be solved. Personally, I think this is what's going to happen. But until that happens, the mystery remains. But it might be solved before then due to the fact that Tabitha Boyajian and her colleagues are monitoring the star. So far they have not observed any dips, but when they do, spectrographs will be pointed towards the star and will be able to tell if the objects blocking the light are solid objects or a cloud of dust and gas. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently getting better at rattling off number solid star names, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for in-depth, regular explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.